everybody. How you doing today? I'm going to talk about a topic right now that I am loving so much in makeup. I feel like we kind of go through phases, at least I do, of the part of the makeup routine that I'm most enthusiastic about. And sometimes it's eyes. Sometimes I'll go through periods of time where I just love like the foundation, concealer, powder type steps. Really enjoy that right now too. But my main thing right now that I'm loving are the face color steps. So like bronzers, blushes, highlights, and I love products that are infusing some sort of glow, and I'm loving using a palette. And here's why. I feel like when you pick up a palette, single products are great. You'll find some amazing single things, but palettes are where you can really play. They are where you can take one shade and make it look a bunch of different ways. You can multiply the effects by doing a little mixing and having fun, and you'll realize what like little combinations work best for you that you like the best, and you can do something slightly different every day. So it's the chance, it's the possibility, it's the promise of having a lot of variety without really doing any extra effort. It's like if you can move your hand 2 inches left, right, up, or down, like you can have fun with a palette. So part of what I'm talking about in this video are some newish things. Some are older rediscovered things. But every palette incorporates some element of glow or is an important player in, I think, pulling the whole look together, you know? So I just gotta jump in and talk about it. As far as my eye look today, I did kind of a springy look with my Once palette. I've got Grateful in here on the inner part of the lid. I've got Prayer in the crease, a mix of Pie Fi and Family in my outer corner, and a mix of Family and Belle Violet on the lower lash line. So just kind of like a delicate use of color today. I like that. And then on my lips, they are so dry. I am getting over a cold and they're just so dry. This is my Je ne sais quoi, like kind of lip balm stick from It Cosmetics. It's in the honey shade, which this is kind of the true color that is. It's sort of like a muted warm pink, actually. And I've got just a little bit of my Milani Spice lip liner on to even that out. And cheek-wise, I've got a few of the products I'm going to be talking about today. So, to reference a little bit of inspiration here for this kind of video, this palette, I've talked about it to no end. Trust me, it's going to be brief in this video if you're bored to tears on the topic of Too Faced Sugar Peach. But it does have, like, a lot of elements that I like and that do apply to these favorites, and it kind of like stirred me a little bit to find more different products that I like as well. But one little misconception about this palette, everything in here is shimmery, and I saw a couple comments saying like if you were to use all that, you'd be just way too shimmery on your face. And I do want to offer a little food for thought on that, because let's say you're going to use the Peach Honey, like a light bronzer all over the skin. The same concepts apply as like if you're doing a one shadow look on your eyes. There are some shades that you're going to lay down more intense, like a highlight with a smaller, more pinpointed brush, right? That's going to get the intensity. Larger brushes, more of a buffing type application, really does change the intensity of any shimmer in any shimmery product that you use. So I can put Peach Honey on my skin, not necessarily see a lot of glow because I'm applying it with a brush this size, and I'm really like almost circular motion buffing it in. Then if I put on the highlight in this palette with a brush this size and practically just like lay it right down on the cheek, I'm really seeing that, okay? And I'm seeing more of the shimmery intensity. So just keep that in mind. We've talked about that a lot with like one shadow looks and how you can make a shimmer work in your crease, let's say. It's by using a fuller brush and a buffing type motion as opposed to a packing motion. So the same kind of applies for face products. So if you think, gosh, I can't get away with a bronzer that's got any glow or a blush that's got any glow, think about your brush usage, think about the manner in which you're applying and how much is actually on your brush. So this palette is a great palette, and I think it kind of prompted me to want to find more. First thing I will mention is actually this Contour 1 from Profusion. I believe this also comes in the Contour 2, which is deeper, but I love this palette. I've really actually grown to love the highlights that are in here, but I use this for contouring all the time. I used it in my look today. I used a lot of the Tan Sculpt kind of around my hairline. I ended up pulling in a little mix of the Light Sculpt around the cheekbones and down the neck and chest, and those are just really good tones. It's a very nice texture of powder. I can use this matte shade as like under eye setting powder, and these two highlights here are actually quite beautiful. One is a bit more peachy and one is more like your classic champagne, but they look beautiful on the skin, and I've just like, this is less than $5, okay? You're gonna find this stuff at Walmart now, the Profusion stuff. And for that price, the feel, the nice soft texture of these powders, and the versatility that this palette will offer you with the glow and the matte, the contour and the highlight. The one matte light creamy shade in here that's very valuable to me. I love this palette. Also on the topic of Profusion and their blush palettes, I love, love, love these. I have the blush one and the blush two. As you can see, the blush two, deeper, richer shades. The blush one, there are even colors in here that show up much more intense than you would expect. Plan on everything in these being very pigmented, like even this color called Delight. Like, I really see that on my cheeks. But what I really enjoy about these palettes is that they popped in a variety of finishes. So you've got like this kind of a satin, a soft kind of bronzy, comes off with a little rose gold sheen right here. Shimmery blushes over on this side. So there are a lot of things offering that glow. There are a lot of things in this palette that I like layering up with some highlights that I'm going to be mentioning here in a minute, but I initially underestimated the blush one for my skin tone. I just kind of glanced at it and thought before I'd tried either of these that maybe they wouldn't be so pigmented. You know, $5 Walmart blush palette, what are you gonna get? Well, everything in here really, really shows on me, and I just love that beautiful variety. And then the blush two, I can still wear the blush two. I've got to be a little bit more light-handed with the deepest colors over here, but you've got a nice bright pink. You've got these three shimmers here, and then this one has some shimmer also. I love these palettes. I love the glow that they incorporate and the great pigmentation. And that like $4.88 price tag. What's up? I absolutely must mention this because this is part of like the underlying enthusiasm for this video. My Beauty Bakery Cotton Candy Champagne palette. So this is all about the blush here, the glowy blush. They call these blush lighters, and I love that new term. I've talked about this and put this on in a couple of recent videos, but all the shades are so gorgeous. I cannot choose between them. One's a little kind of like plummy, little more bronzy neutral, but this is very much a blush. Don't get me wrong, corally and pink. And the glow that is mixed with these shades, as that works in on the skin, it is so dang pretty. Like, this is the ultimate glowy blush collection. And I even mentioned, like with my Sephora recommendations video, I was recommending the Becca Luminous Blushes. You know, kind of rediscovered those recently, really liking them, but this is almost like a collection of that style and that softness and that beautiful blushy pigment, but in a four pan palette that I just don't think you're ever going to get tired of. Like, I love this. And a lot of times I will pair that with a highlight from here. So not that you would absolutely have to put highlight on top of these blushes, but if you just want, you know, a little something extra, my Luminizer Squad from The Balm. This is so great. I love this so much. I love the tones. I use this all the dang time. So Mary Luminizer, the really like well-known, probably most popular highlight from The Balm. Very much your classic champagne. I think it's really bright enough to show off with some pop on any skin tone. Cindy Luminizer, see, this is a bit more of a blush topper. It's softer in its shimmer and it's more peachy. And then down here we have Penny Luminizer, which is probably my least used, but it is very pretty. It's a bright kind of goldeny highlight, but it's not brassy. It's not too dark gold, so it can definitely work on me. And then I love this Emma Lou. This is one of the ones that I knew was like, I guess, only in this palette. And alongside these other shades, I see why you might think, is that almost blue toned? No, it does not look blue on the skin, but it does have just maybe the teeniest bit of lilac happening in there. It is so dang brightening. I think you've seen this applied in some videos. Anything that gets that cool is going to just look so next level bright on the skin, and it's fun to pair it with different blushes and just see how it comes off. But I adore this palette, and these, some of these aren't like the most shimmery, like Cindy Lou and Emma Lou. It's so much fun to pair that with this, and you feel like you've got all the options you would need. Now, I was watching Michelle Bell's, I need to put her exact like Instagram username. She's on YouTube as well, but I was watching her Instagram stories, and she was talking about trying to track down this Milani Rose Glow Stellar Lights palette. She said people were talking about how amazing it was, and it made me want to go out and try to find it too. Now, this is really, really intense. I would say everything I'm mentioning in this video, even if you've got a little texture, even if you've got a few little fine lines and problem areas on the skin, I genuinely feel like the things I'm recommending in this video aren't gonna make those issues worse, aren't going to exaggerate those problems. This is beautifully intense, but I do think you might wanna watch yourself a little bit because it is the most like metallic in terms of these highlights, like very, very strong highlights. Only takes a little, but I'm liking it. Like I'm liking to play with it. I'm liking to splash in, you know, a little bit of that lightest shade, maybe with a certain look that I'm wearing. Even mix a little bit of the coppery color, like right onto the apple of the cheek. They're really, really nice, but like in comparison, for example, to Mary Luminizer, which is a well-known highlight from The Balm, like these are way, way stronger than that. So for somebody who likes just ultra, ultra metallic, see it from outer space type highlight, you might like this, but I do like the palette form, the ability to mix, the ability to take this lightest shade and kind of mix it in with either of these other two to bring them to a different level, you know? I think that's cool. That's my one thing in this video, like use with caution. And then my last thing to mention here, and this will give you a little closure on the demo, this is my Ulta Baked Sculpt and Glow. And I love how, you know, 1 week I'm talking about, oh, the Ulta brand just doesn't really excite me. And then I'm remembering a really good thing that I have from Ulta brand. This is in the shade Tahitian Sunset. Now this is really like Ulta's sort of dupe on a great product Laura Geller put out that was shaped and like divided up exactly like this. So this is like a baked kind of domed product here, but you've got this sort of glowy bronzer, glowy blush, and a beautiful highlight. Now, I am finding more and more that there is a place for the lighter toned glowy bronzers in my look. I'm really seeing the value. You know, I've come into enjoying my Too Faced Sun Bunny a lot lately. Different products like this that I'm running into in some palettes here and there. And what I did after I contoured, I took this and I just kind of went all over the skin. And I love how soft these colors are. Like, this is not dry, baked, flaky. These are like beautifully soft pigmented textures in here. It's amazing, beautiful. So I kind of just go all over the skin, like dust it around the hairline, but let it come on top of the cheeks. Let it come where the sun naturally hits. And then this blush is so beautiful. It's like a rose swirled with gold. And I thought that made a really, really pretty glowy blush that I could have been satisfied like stopping there. But the highlight in here, this is so brightening. It's a little bit got that pinky coolness, just an icy effect as it goes across the skin, but it's pearly. It's got a real wearability to it, if you know what I mean. So Tahitian Sunset, love the tones in there. This comes in several other tone options, but I can tell you for a fact, I really love this one. So surprising Ulta brand find there, but I'm not sure you can still get the Laura Geller like trio of products that's like this, but I have no doubt that this is cheaper and the textures are fabulous. So friends, I'm not sure what I'm going to call this video, like glowy palette roundup, because everything in here, you know, plays a role in the glow, whether you're contouring a little bit, whether it's a blush, whether it's a highlight, it all comes together for that finished look that makes you just think, ugh, juicy cheeks, you know? If you've got any products like this in your collection, let me know what they are, like dig around. Tell me about any other products I might not know about that come under this heading, but these are just a few to give you a little inspiration. So thank you so much for watching, everybody. I appreciate your time, your viewership, your wonderful comments. I'm not worthy. Thank you so much, and I'll see you soon. Bye.